Okay, folks, welcome back. Mike Bates, Refine Fitness Studio for Refine TV. This week, we're going to talk about one of the big myths that a lot of people have out there about getting started on an exercise program, and in particular, working with a personal trainer. So there's this mentality out there that you need to be in shape before you start to work with the trainer. We have lots of clients who've taken time off, and that's the kiss of death in my world. When someone says, I'm going to take some time off, or I'm going to try and do it on my own, that's basically a recipe for disaster, meaning they're going to fail, they're going to fall off, and they're going to stop exercising. And I am the eternal optimist, but I'm also a realist when it comes to exercise. I know my clients, busy professionals, adults who have not exercised on a regular basis, have not shown a commitment to it for a long term on their own, and they're not going to be accountable to it. So when they say they're going to try it on their own, I'm normally pretty honest with them in saying, that normally means you're not going to keep up with the exercise program. You need some level of accountability. You're busy. You're not sure what to do. You're not going to push yourself the same way. So we need to stay in touch with you. Okay. So very, very important when we hear those words, what they mean. And we try and be honest with people based on our experience, because people think they know themselves better than they do. When it comes to exercise and making change, I firmly believe that I know you better than you know yourself most of the time. Okay. So this concept of getting in shape before you work with a personal trainer, okay? People just feel like I need to, you know, the common things we'll hear is, well, before I get started with the trainer, maybe I'm going to start doing some treadmill work or go for some walks before, then I'll get ready to work with the trainer. It's an absolutely misguided concept. People think that personal trainers can only work at one speed, and it's full out, 100%, kind of kick your butt until you can't move at the end of a session. That is not the kind of trainer you should work with, and that's not the kind of trainer I would ever hire in my facility. Trainers can work at various speeds based on the intensity, the fitness level, the health condition, and the age of the client that they've got. And that's critically important. It's really one of the major differentiating factors that makes a really great trainer, okay? So thinking that you need to get in shape before you work with a personal trainer really isn't accurate. The best, if you had to choose whether you could start working with a trainer at the start of an exercise program or halfway through, I would always say start with a personal trainer, because they're going to they're going to get you off to the right start, help you set some realistic goals. They're going to make a time efficient and effective workout. They're going to show you the exercise modifications that you need to make based on your body, aches and pains, any injuries you've got. They're going to push you at an appropriate level, and they're going to take the thinking out of designing the exercise program. And you're going to do both. You're going to get some cardiovascular exercise and you're going to get some strength training, but it's going to be done at an appropriate level. Always suggest starting out here, baseline, and then slowly ramping up as your fitness level improves, as your energy levels improve, as your confidence improves, and overall as your body improves. So think about exercise as a slow climbing set of stairs, not one big jump to the top. We have to progress you slowly. And the best personal trainers get that, they understand that, and they don't have an ego if a client says, wow, that workout was too easy for me. That doesn't hurt their feelings. They say, great, that's awesome that you feel that way. Let's see how you feel in a couple days when you come back, and if you don't have a lot of soreness, then we can start pushing you a little bit more. Most of the time when that person comes back after their first workout, they're gonna have some regular moderate muscle soreness. We don't want severe muscle soreness. We want moderate, low to moderate muscle soreness. And that's to be expected. But if it's beyond that, that means they were pushed a little bit too hard, or maybe we underestimated their where their fitness actually was, or sometimes the client isn't being honest with us and telling us how they're actually feeling in an exercise session. But at the end of the day, we want to progress slowly with someone's exercise. And that does not mean slow results. We are all about maximizing results in someone's first month, and we've shown that time and time again. So I don't at all want you to think that that's gonna minimize someone's results. So if you think you need to get in shape to work with a personal trainer, you are absolutely incorrect. Find the right trainer first who can start you out at the right level, and they will slowly progress you. It is absolutely the best way to get started on your exercise program. Okay, thanks for checking in. Mike Bates from Refine TV.